does a coach do? So tell me, what do we think? What does a coach do?
Teach.
Inspire.
Yells.
Inspire. Strategy.
Train.
Yells. Now here's the great thing. The coach has insight.
Screams.
And the players, usually if it's a good coach, they respect the coach. Because the coach is going to sometimes tell them how to do something. Sometimes a coach is about asking questions. Sometimes the coach doesn't just tell you. It's like, so Karen, how do you think that last play went? Well, it's like, not so well, coach. Why? Now, does the coach already know? Absolutely. Now, is it better for the coach just to tell them? No. Because the goal is, the coaches, they want the student or the athlete to change. They want the student or athlete to get the insight to ha, so it becomes a lesson that they embody. Otherwise, the coach is like, no need to think, Karen. I'll just always watch you, and I'll always tell you what to do. Always. That's a horrible coach. Because all they've done is correct their behavior that the student or athlete doesn't need to think. So the whole point of the coach has the insights, but sometimes tells them, because sometimes just telling is the right thing. Other times it's like help them realize it themselves, help them arrive at the answer so that student or athlete can go, oh, yes. Because if there's no, that's not a lesson. That's a, I realize in this particular moment I could have done it better differently. But it hasn't sunk in where it's, that's what you're going after. All right. So as a court hoop leader, what's your role? Referee, coach, or cheerleader?
All of
you. Okay, here's what I want you to do. What is your role percentage? I'd like you to talk at a table. You're going to have 37 seconds at the table. Then I'm going to assess your table. What percentage of coach, referee, or cheerleader? Break it up 100%. Yes.
What is it or what should it be?
What should it be? Thank you for clarifying that, Mr. Teacher. Live. You have 37 seconds. Go.
Hey. 300%.
How many percentage do we have? So our discussion time is over. We now need to know what do you believe is the correct ratio, starting with referee, cheerleader, coach.
10-20-70.
This group right here, what do you got?
20-20-60.
This one over here.
20-20-60.
515-80. You said it depends on the student.
Lane! Okay, over here. Can you even ask a clarifying question what to do when you get failed? No more discussion for you. All right, Dave, over here.
We said 8.25, 17.5, and 74.
What?
Excellent. I'll just blend you with that table. Now we had slightly different percentages, but it really came down to minority, majority. So this is the role. So what a shocker. I agree with you. So a little bit more about this particular role. So, okay, knowing that we want to be a coach, what's a technique that we can do to help us kind of think about it differently and have some slightly different type of interactions at times, depending upon what you feel like doing here? All right, so first I'll talk about, okay, what is the role of a core group coach? This is my opinion. I did get Phil to sign off at him, okay, about 8:30 this morning, but still, it's like, this is my opinion, is to help students get a clear vision of what a disciple is. They don't inherently show up. No matter how many years of Sunday school that they've been going at, it's like in junior high and high school, it's like that's still a work in progress. And so helping them get a clear idea of what it is before they even start to try and live it, they've got to have that. That's something that's going to be a team action between Alex and Kyle, who are, in essence, preaching that message, and then you who are leading discussions. That's why you have discussion groups, because no matter how good of a job Kyle and Alex do, that alone isn't going to do the trick. All right? Next thing is to model Christian behaviors. Apparently, hypocrisy is not considered a best practice in student ministry. So you gotta have it, all right? And then the third here, and this is what we're gonna be talking about, is a role of coach. To engage, encourage, recognize, and appreciate, and provide positive and constructive feedback on Christian living. Now let's kind of break that down. To engage, encourage, recognize, and appreciate. I remember in 1984, when I got my first job out of college, and I went through the executive management training program for the Broadway department store, which is now Macy's, like every other department store in the world. And so I'm starting out there, and I went through this training, and I'm thinking, I don't know anything. And I remember they throw me into, okay, you're now a department manager, and all these people who've been working there for 20 years, you're now their boss. And they're thinking, oh, gosh, you're so pathetic. And I'm thinking, I am. I don't know how to tell them what to do, because I don't understand the job. But a very wise training manager took me aside and said, Brian, there's one thing people cannot provide for themselves, and that's appreciation and recognition. Technically, those are two things, but I chose not to correct them. All right, so appreciation and recognition. Now, there are students that go in and say, yes, thank you so much. I'm so awesome. How awesome am I? Did you see that? I am so awesome. And what do we think inside our heads when we see these self-promoting students? How sad, how insecure are they? Because no one respects self-appreciation. No one respects self-recognition. Recognition has to come from others. Now, there's a certain level of recognition you get from peers, but to have another adult in a Christian setting to give you recognition and appreciation and acknowledgement for progress you've made, and you're not their parent, huge, because they can get that nowhere else. Certain level of encouragement, recognition, appreciation, and also provide positive and constructive feedback on Christian living. Few people say, I remember my coach was so great, they never challenged me. No, it was a cakewalk. Whatever I did was great. That no one will ever describe their favorite coach that way. I remember I was in the volleyball team, and boy, she pushed me. She said, you did a great job, but you were capable of so much more. Here's how I want you to adjust your serve at the volleyball. Boom. So, and I went, I practiced and practiced and practiced. And I took my first serves. I got them from 87 to 96.2% in two games because of this technique that she gave me, because she believed in me. Good coaches challenge and stretch. Now, also good coaches also correct, because constructive feedback, which is nicer than saying negative feedback, which of course what it really is. But we don't like saying negative, so we say constructive. But constructive, because there are a lot of people, it's like they want to do well, but they're not. And they need us to come alongside them and guide them, so there's ways to do that. All right, so we're going to be talking about a technique that we can do to do number three. All right, here are the three times that we can coach when it comes to giving positive or constructive feedback. One is good behavior, and I'm calling them relational behaviors, because generally I think in core groups when we're talking about, a lot of times we're talking about behaviors, but you could substitute anything there. Relational behaviors that meet or exceed expectations. Meet or exceed expectations as a Christian disciple, as a high school or junior high student, or middle school student. We have certain expectations that we've talked about. When they are meeting or exceeding them, it's like, this is a great time to provide positive reinforcement, because it's like, I remember in a work environment, someone says, you ever work for a manager who says, I'm never going to thank you for doing your job. That's awesome. I don't wish to work for you. How about that? Katie was in eighth grade, it's like, you were on the soccer team, and you all get a trophy! Yay! Okay, that's what you need, okay? But as we get older, that's less so, because the meritocracy kicks in, and you get praised for behavior that you do, not just for showing up. So this is what about. So when people meet or exceed expectations, it's like we've got to give them reinforcement, or they will do it less. They will do it less. Now here's where it gets interesting. For poor